I am next door to a very horny couple. Say a prayer for me.
I've travelled further than ever for more sleepovers.
Lindsay, hi. Hi.
And this time I'm crossing the pond.
Welcome to America.
Thank you.
We're extraordinary families.
I have 36 guns just on my own.
Wow.
Good time.
Invite me to stay in their homes.
Oh, good girl.
Last few videos we posted, Cheryl had on this schoolgirl skirt, and it was very hot.
And share their lives with me for one weekend.
Are you happy to talk me through the day that you found out you were pregnant with Carson?
I was like, damn.
I'm in Georgia, one of America's most conservative southern states.
I am genuinely so excited about this weekend, I can't begin to tell you. I have been so intrigued by this family.
I'm on my way to meet two people whose recent marriage has caused a stampede of curiosity in the world's media. There's nothing unique about couples making dance videos on TikTok. The reason these guys have caused such a stir is their age gap.
So, Karan is in his 20s, Cheryl's in her 60s, there's 38 years between them. We've seen that the other way around. We've seen lots of young women with, you know, much older men, and we're much more programmed to accept that. But the response they receive online is bonkers.
Far from shying away from the often cruel comments they'll receive, the couple have sought to monetize the attention they're getting, whether it's good or bad.
60.1 million likes. So there's clearly an appetite for this kind of content. So for me, the reason that this setup is so fascinating is Karan. It's that handsome young lad in his 20s. He's got it all ahead of him. Cheryl is in her 60s. She's probably lived most of her life. Realistically, what is their future going to look like? I'm 35. I couldn't even date, like, someone in their 20s.
I want to learn what's driving their unwavering desire for attention and find out how it's impacted their lives. Can two people with nearly four decades between them really find true love?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello. Really
how
nice to see. I'm spot on. Are you okay?
Yes.
Nice, I'm Stacey.
I'm Cheryl.
Lovely to see you,
nice
Cheryl.
To meet you.
Come on, how's things?
Pretty good, and yourself?
Yeah, I'm good. Thank you for having me. I'm
no
really,
problem.
Really grateful. Can I have a look round?
Yes.
Do you mind? So this is the aquarium.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
We have 10
turtles.
We started with two and then it grew, so.
I won't ask all their names because I'll never remember them. So this is your bedroom.
Yes.
Cheryl and Karan live in a one bedroom flat, which they share with their ever growing pet collection.
Oh, wow.
Like, yeah, that's Tarzan and that's Bella.
Tarzan and Bella?
Mm-hmm.
Hello. Well, listen, I'm going to kip on the sofa, is that all right?
Yes.
And Karan, I'm saying your name right, aren't I?
You are,
yeah.
And I'm so grateful for
yeah,
that.
Karan.
Yeah, a lot of people don't. I didn't at first. I called him Kwan.
Yeah, she did.
So talk me through what we got planned for this weekend.
So we have a barbecue, skating. We're going to church. It's Cheryl's birthday weekend at that.
Cheryl, it's your birthday this weekend?
Yes.
What day?
Sunday.
Stop it. This Sunday?
Yes.
How old are you going to be?
62.
Right. Thank you for having me on such a special weekend. My first impressions, there's a real lovely dynamic between the pair of them. There is a real rapport, like they're very sort of tactile and there's a sweetness to Cheryl. Everything's sort of quite chill, anything goes, and Karan's quite laid back as well and quite sort of quiet. I'm sort of not down with the ferrets.
So I'm really praying that they stay in the cage the whole time, because I've got visions of me waking up at silly o'clock with a ferret on my face, but I'm sure I'll be fine.
Karan and Cheryl initially became friends 2 years ago through their shared love of dancing. After a video they made went viral with nearly 100,000 likes, the pair became TikTok partners and then moved in with each other 6 months later.
So what are you cooking, Karan?
Cajun shrimp Alfredo.
Wow, fancy. And do you tend to do most of the cooking?
I do.
Yeah?
I love cooking, and I feel like Cheryl cooked for all her kids. She shouldn't have to cook for me.
How many kids has Cheryl got?
She got 7 kids.
Stop. Are some of them older than you?
All of them are.
Really?
Yeah.
How old are they?
29, 32, 34, 36, 40, and
42, I think. So, of course, for them, it's a massive shock that their mum's got this, like, young toy boy.
Most definitely. It is what it is. You want to cut some sausage while we sit here?
Yes, yes. Tell me, when did you start to realize that you had feelings for Cheryl?
I felt like I had romantic feelings when I had this dream. First, the dream was like, make way, the king and queen is coming through. It was me and Cheryl. Like, and I remember that dream. I was like, what the hell? Like, I wasn't even looking at her in that light. And I seen that my brain thought she was something special, so.
Stop. So this, Cheryl's the first older woman that you've been into?
Cheryl was actually the first woman I've been with.
Really?
Intimately, yeah. I had a girlfriend before, but she wasn't the one for me. And so I decided to wait. And Cheryl's the first woman I was actually intimate with.
So you lost your virginity to Cheryl?
Mm-hmm.
Incredible. Hey, Bella.
Originally from California, Cheryl has 7 children from 4 previous relationships.
How's it doing?
And 17 grandkids.
Stacey.
Yeah?
Here you go.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you. Thank
she married Karan in 2021.
Yay! Congratulations!
Lord, bless this food. Let it nourish each and every part of our body. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Do you remember how you felt, Cheryl, when Karan said, look, I've got these romantic feelings?
I said, I didn't want our friendship to be broken up. So
you didn't want to jeopardize the friendship?
No, not at all. I didn't. And he said, if we feel that it's not working out, then we can go back to being friends. I said, okay. And it went from there.
Were you immediately attracted to him?
Well, yeah. When we started seeing each other and we knew that we were interested in each other, yeah. Definitely.
That's a lovely stage, isn't it? You know, when you're just starting to vibe with each other and you think,
it is.
I fancy him.
It's kind of scary, though, because you're like, I don't know. Like, what am I getting myself into? But we like the same foods, and he likes to dance. So I like to dance. We like to have fun. So we turned that into doing it on TikTok.
And how does it feel, Cheryl, knowing that you're Karan's first ever girlfriend?
You meaning like I took his virginity?
Yeah.
Yes. I didn't know that until he told me after, and I was like, no. If you take somebody's virginity, pretty much it means a lot to that person.
It's a big deal.
So you have, very big deal.
Were you into Cheryl more than Cheryl was into you, or was it fairly balanced?
I mean, in the beginning, I was more into her.
So you pursued Cheryl?
Yeah.
Funny, isn't it? Our life goes.
Cheryl and Karan's intimacy is a big part of people's curiosity towards them. And they're not exactly shy about sharing. Staying in the southern state of Georgia with social media influencers Cheryl and Karan, whose 37-year age gap has divided opinion. I've been invited to hang out with Karan's family, who live on the other side of town.
What y'all should be expecting is a good southern home-cooked meal, like potato salad, hamburgers, hot dogs, ribs, chicken. My mom's really creative when it comes to this, so.
Karan's mum, Tammy, is the host.
Hi, how is Stacey?
Hi, Stacey, I'm Tammy.
How are you, Tammy?
I'm peachy. Good. I love your pants.
Oh, thank you.
You got the new distress look.
It's like built-in aircon because it's so hot.
Yes, you and know? It's more roomy, too.
Tammy,
yes.
Thanks for having us over.
Okay, I'm glad. I'm glad y'all can come and be part of the family.
Karan's family includes Grandma Pearl, Grandpa Bob, and sisters Olivia and Ashley.
You want a hamburger?
No, I just want my chicken.
All right.
I'm curious how easy it was for the family to accept Cheryl.
Oh, there you
Thank you, Tammy.
Particularly Karan's mum, who found herself with a daughter-in-law 16 years her senior.
I am dying to know what your reaction was when you first met Cheryl.
I was shocked. I was a little upset. The way I found out was whenever they went and got married. They got eloped.
They eloped? So you didn't know they were together romantically? I didn't realize that.
No. That's why I was like, you got married to your TikTok friend?
How did you find out?
TikTok.
Stop it, Tammy.
I looked and there's pictures on there and it's like, wait, these are wedding pictures. Yeah, we got married, see?
Tammy. And then when they returned, do you remember that first conversation between you and Karan?
I think my thing was why. I thought you all was just friends.
Right. What are your concerns?
My concern is pretty much is just that you're in your 20s, you know. You don't have no kids. You know, you're going to go live your life and then settle down in your 30s.
What do you think Karan sees in Cheryl?
I think it's just her personality. I'm trying to get to know her. You know, I'm trying without Karan, you know, because trying to get that mother-in-law and daughter-in-law bond.
Yeah.
So I'm trying, but my thing is, I really don't know her. I don't.
I suppose it's unknown territory, isn't it? Because you haven't got a huge amount in common. So whilst the will is there, you know, you want this relationship.
Yeah.
You probably don't know how to start.
No, I don't.
Start it.
I really don't.
What?
Despite some reservations, it seems the family are making the effort to help Cheryl feel accepted.
And you feel like...
I'm tired inside.
And they're a pretty fun bunch, really.
To the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. Right foot, left stop.
I'm
left
very good at the toughest side.
Hot.
But not as good as Cheryl. Okay, Tammy, I'm behind you.
Slide to the left. Slide to the right. Crisscross. Crisscross. Let's go to work.
I'm good, aren't I? It's unexpected, but I'm great. I should have been leading, shouldn't I? I'm quite good. I think it's fair to say that there are some family members that are still trying to suss it out. You know, they accept that they're together and they want to be supportive and they love Karan. And they want to make sure that Cheryl feels comfy, but there's this nagging sort of question in the back of their minds in terms of why.
In some ways, there's something very American about the way Karan and Cheryl manage their relationship brand. Their PR is loud, and they don't hold back on the self-promotion.
I am done. You've got your own merch.
Yeah.
Stop this! I am finished. They are fantastic. Love that for you.
I'm gonna go get you.
Today has been completely fascinating. I think everybody is desperate to try and figure them out. There are outsiders thinking, oh, there must be an ulterior motive, like, what's the setup? I just want to figure out who they are, what their relationship looks like, and you know, what life is like day to day.
Something that has become very clear is how important TikTok social media is to them. It plays a massive part in their lives. He's already done like a handful of videos. I think there's more of that to come.
It's my second day with Cheryl and Karan.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Cheryl still works part-time on a checkout, but Karan has left his caretaking job and now focuses full-time on creating online content. Today, they're making some videos for their increasingly lucrative TikTok account.
We might need someone to film.
Do you want me to film? I can film. I'm going to press the red button, and then will it start immediately?
Yeah, back up.
Okay, don't fall in the water, for God's sake.
Oh, no, we're good, because we're not going nowhere.
Happy? 3, 2.
Hey, you did great for your first TikTok.
Oh, my gosh, am I a director?
Amazing, that is amazing.
Their pay is dependent on the number of views and the amount of engagement their videos receive.
Don't know how good that was.
Like, I don't know. No, that might not have been good.
On average, Cheryl and Karan make $3,500 a month from making 2 or 3 10-second videos a day, mostly of them dancing.
So Cheryl, tell me how your video's done.
It is done 32.1K in 3 hours, which is really good, and that's likes.
That's likes.
Mm-hmm.
And over 3,100 comments.
Mm-hmm.
You don't tend to go through those comments.
No, I try to stay out of them, especially when they're new, because they're bad.
Ever tempting? Or if you
taught
yourself?
Yeah, it is, but I'm not going to put myself through that. Their opinion even means nothing to me. Why should I let it affect and ruin my day?
Would I be allowed to have a quick look at the comments?
Yep, you sure can.
Okay. I mean, there are a couple of nice ones. Something I've seen a couple of times is, they're only together to stay relevant on TikTok. How does that make you feel?
At the end of the day, this is our love. A lot of people are speculating our love. Mm-hmm. You can say whatever you want, how you feel, mm-hmm. and we can't control that, and that's understandable. But regardless if we were on TikTok or not, our life still isn't normal to society.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not going to be accepted on the internet or in real life because of the age gap.
So are you saying that you would always be up against it, even if you weren't online, because people have an issue day-to-day with the age gap?
Age gap in the interracial part, because we're in the southern states, and a lot of people don't agree with an older white woman with a younger black man. They just find that completely disgusting.
Wow.
That's like a crime, basically, in the southern states.
But TikTok is not the whole story. Aside from innocent dance videos, the couple have started venturing into more mature content.
And you're on other apps?
We have Instagram, we have YouTube, we have a Twitter,
uh-huh.
and we have our OnlyFans.
What do those videos look like?
So with those videos, we are adult entertainers.
Are you happy to sort of give me an example? I'm an adult. You can speak freely.
Okay, well, last few videos we posted, Cheryl's dressed up in lingerie.
Oh.
She had on this schoolgirl skirt, and it was very hot, like it was smoking. Cheryl has a very hot body, like
uh-huh,
it's very nice.
Yeah. The content on OnlyFans, you have to subscribe.
Yes.
So you pay a certain amount each month.
Mm-hmm. My OnlyFans cost $11, I believe, to subscribe. Cheryl OnlyFans is $15.
How many subscribers do you have?
I say we're about 2,400.
And what do your family make of these videos?
Woo! Some of my kids are disturbed, very much disturbed about it.
Do they feel like you've been pressured into it, or do they accept that it was a sort of 50-50 decision?
At first, one of them did, and I told him, no, I wasn't. I said, he doesn't force me. I do it on my own.
So the plan is to continue with OnlyFans.
Yeah, people really like to watch us make love and share passionate moments.
The enormous public intrigue of the 37-year age gap between Cheryl and Karan has allowed them to make a career creating online content. But what started with innocent dance videos has progressed to adult home movies.
Not much shocks me, but this is super graphic.
For the cost of around $11 a month, fans of Karan and Cheryl can tune into what they get up to in the bedroom.
Half of me thinks, well, good for you, Cheryl. You know what I mean? Like, just because she's in her 60s doesn't mean that she never wants to be touched again or pleasured. I thought it was going to be more suggestive. I thought the camera was going to be like in the corner of the room and you could sort of see what was going on. But the camera is here and you can see the texture of Karan's penis and the pores on Cheryl's vagina. It's close. You know, I have no emotional attachment. You know, if it was my mum receiving oral from a 20-something year old, I'd probably feel slightly different.
I'm keen to find out exactly how Cheryl feels about her venture into porn.
Tell me about the OnlyFans account. Do you enjoy making videos?
Yeah, because it's with him and it's, we don't look at it like we're doing half. Sometimes, you know, it's a job.
When he first suggested the idea, what was your reaction?
Wasn't a decision that I made right away. And then when he told me that he really can't see much of me at all, but you can tell what we're doing and you can see more of him than me, so I'm good with that.
There's quite a lot of you on show, isn't there, though?
Most of mine is my legs, you can tell. Other than that, I mean, it's not like he shows my whole body.
Your vagina's on show, isn't it, quite clear?
Not really, really, just like this angle.
Yeah.
It is what it is. I mean, we make money off doing that too.
And I know, Cheryl, there'll be people screaming, oh, he's pressuring her into these videos.
No,
you know, she's vulnerable, he's taking advantage.
In my right mind in all aspects. He ain't taking advantage of me. I know what's going on. I'm not stupid. I have my own mind and my own beliefs and my own feelings. And nobody's going to tell me. I feel what I feel and I say what I say.
Good for you.
By sharing every aspect of their lives online, the couple make themselves easy targets.
Thank you.
Earlier this year, they gave their haters even more ammunition when they announced they wanted to start a family. Despite cries of protest from trolls, the couple are determined to go ahead with having a baby.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
They've invited me to meet 19-year-old Elizabeth, who's keen to help make their dream come true.
I was talking to my coworkers, and I was like letting them know, well, like, I'm going to start a surrogacy soon. I'm so excited, but I'm really nervous about the pain. And they were like, oh, get that epidural. You're not going to feel any pain. I was like, yeah. Y'all have that contract yet?
We're going to make sure we get it signed by the end of the month because
okay. We're
not waiting past August. We wanted the baby to be here at least by late spring, early summer.
So it's happening ASAP.
Oh, yeah, as soon as possible.
Like the end of this month?
Yes. The end of this month.
Wow. Tell me how you guys met, how this all came about.
Well, I was actually their server when I worked at Olive Garden in town. And I went up to my table and I was like, hi, my name's Elizabeth. How can I... Are you? And they were like, yeah, we're on a date. Just keep it down on the low. And I was like, well, there's no possible way I can do that. This is like the biggest couple celebrity I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, so you recognize them straight away?
Straight away.
So you were super starstruck.
Oh, yeah. I was like, oh, but I'm like freaking out, you know, like just so excited.
So you're a genuine fan.
Oh, yeah.
How did the conversation progress? Because there's one thing being a fan.
Right.
Right.
You know, yeah. It's quite another thing to say, do you know what, I'm up for carrying your child.
She actually consistently wrote us throughout the months, congratulations on y'all proposal and the engagement and the marriage. And then she was like, I heard y'all were looking for a kid, like a surrogate.
I just kind of thought about myself, like, why would I not be a good fit? So I reached out and then we met up and it sounded right for both of us.
Pretty amazing.
What a ride you're all in for.
I know, I'm so excited.
I know some women have found it psychologically difficult to hand over the child that they've carried. Is that something that you've thought about?
It's something that I've thought about. People have told me to really consider it, but I don't think I'll have any real issues with it.
So you think it's going to be quite transactional?
I mean, it's not like the child's going to be out of my life forever. I'll be able to see videos. We live in the same town. If I feel like I'd like to, you know, see the child, that option is available to me.
She will always have us as lifelong friends. And who's to say this is just the only baby that we'll be having, so...
You want more, Karan?
I mean, who knows? Like, that's why she will always be a part of our family, because she helped build our family.
Like an auntie figure?
Yeah, basically, yeah. Yeah.
That's a good way to put it.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you.
She seems like a sweet kid. Like, she's 19, so she's a woman. It's interesting that they were sort of celeb figures to her. I think she was quite sort of starry-eyed. It sounds like they've sort of moved on from that. Cheryl and Karan have said this is about raising a family.
One, two, three.
They use the term love child. There are cynics thinking, you know, is this just another way to sort of generate income and create more content?
Thank y'all.
Because, you know, he said a couple of times, I'll definitely sort of be documenting the whole thing. It's my third day with the couple. This afternoon, they'll be joined by friends and family to celebrate Cheryl's 62nd birthday. Cheryl, look at you. You look lovely.
Thank you.
But I'm sensing a slight hesitance in the air. So Cheryl.
Yes.
Today is your birthday celebration. Be nice to see everyone, wouldn't it? Celebrate you.
Yeah, this will be the first time I've ever done anything like this. I was more focused on the kids and stuff, so we really don't focus on my birthday.
Cheryl, you have to celebrate your birthday. This is the
I did last year and this year. Karan has helped me do this.
But before meeting Karan, you wouldn't really have a party for your birthday.
No.
Cheryl, you have to never do that again.
She won't.
No, I know I won't.
I'm telling you, before me, Cheryl never celebrated anything.
And would you say your confidence has grown over the last couple of years?
Oh, my goodness. Yes. I didn't have no confidence before. None.
Why do you think there was a lack of confidence before?
All my past relationships were abusive, physically, mentally, and this is my first real loving relationship.
So you feel like your first healthy relationship has been when you've been in your 60s?
Yes. Just because he's younger doesn't mean that he's so mature, like in so many ways. He knows how to treat me.
So is it fair to say that Karan has taught you to love yourself?
Uh-huh, very much. He's like, made me feel that there is a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. And he's my pot of gold. It's a good feeling.
For the first time, Cheryl's allowed Karan to organize a get-together for her birthday.
I'm good. How about y'all?
Good.
Hi.
Hey,
come here, Katie.
Hey.
Come here, Finley.
Hey.
Josh is my son, and Aiden and Bentley and Katie is my grandchildren, and this is Josh's wife, Kaylee.
Okay.
Are you guys skating, Bentley?
Yeah, he's ready. So is Katie. She's ready.
Some of Karan's family have also made the effort.
It's a full house.
Cheryl's son, Josh, has seen firsthand how her life has changed since she met Karan.
So I arrived at your mum's at the start of the weekend. She said she's got 7 kids.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you the eldest, the youngest?
I'm the second to the oldest.
The second to the eldest. What do you make of your mother's relationship with Karan?
As long as she's happy, I mean, he makes her happy. I mean, I ain't never seen her this happy in her entire life. So, I mean, as long as he makes her happy, I'm good with it.
When you first found out?
I was like, hell no, he's way younger than me. I ain't about to have that. But as I got to know him and, you know, I'm going to judge him off the muscle, you know. But as I got to know him, you know, he seems like he's a good dude.
What did her previous partners treat her like?
Treat her like shit.
All of them?
Yeah.
And she's got a real presence online now. She's TikTok famous.
Yeah, she's TikTok famous.
She does really interesting videos. Some of them, you know, quite graphic. How do you feel about that?
I don't know. I don't really get into all that, really. It's none of my business, to be honest. You know, Let them live their life. I'm not going to get in their business every time they do something, you know. It's none of my business, you know. She's the happiest she's ever been. I mean, he treats her like an angel. He takes care of her. I mean, she's just a totally different person, man. I mean, and I'm thankful for him to treat her and take care of her, you know. I mean, it's awesome. It really is.
Although her son seems okay with her online presence, many members of the public aren't.
You okay?
Well,
what's wrong?
Cheryl's account's gotten banned while we were in the skating rink.
Cheryl's account just got banned?
Her account.
Her TikTok account?
Her TikTok account.
Why has it got banned?
We have no reasoning right now at the moment.
TikTok have taken it down?
Right.
She's gutted because she did all that work to build it up?
Yes. And this is like our career. We worked hard to get where we are.
Is she in the car?
She is.
Shall I come?
Yes.
If enough people report their content as offensive, their account can be shut down.
Cheryl, are you okay?
No, I'm not.
What's happened?
They banned my account.
Oh, babe, don't cry. Don't cry. don't get upset.
Like, we try to spread positivity. This is what we get. It's all because of the haters. They're massively reporting my account for no reason. If they take my account, then that's all my money gone. All that hard work for no reason. We're not talking about a few bucks. We're talking about a whole bunch of money.
I don't understand why.
Because people love us, and the haters hate that. It's like we don't want to give up, because then we're giving them their dang way.
Yeah.
And I'm not giving up. I'm not. I swear I'm not giving up.
But there's a difference between not understanding your relationship and trying to make your life unbearably difficult.
There's more problems in the age gap, I'm sure. And a lot of it has to do with color. I mean, but they're going to blame it on the age gap regardless. They shouldn't have a problem. They're not living our life. I mean, I'm not going to live forever, but golly, at least give us a chance.
A permanent ban will have serious implications for their finances. But it's also a very personal attack on how they've chosen to live their lives.
It could have happened any other weekend, but y'all do it on her birthday weekend.
You're annoyed because strangers have purposely tried to
make life difficult for Cheryl around her birthday.
This is what they do. Like, the fight ain't over. We're going to use our other social media accounts to fight back.
That's it. That's the spirit. Tomorrow's another day.
You're right. Yeah? Another day to fight.
It's Sunday. And my last day with Cheryl and Karan. Last night, one of Cheryl's accounts was frozen after numerous critics reported her account as offensive. They've been using other platforms to hit back.
I haven't done nothing, and you are doing this for no reason. For what? This is totally destroying me. What have I done to y'all? Like, seriously, what have I done?
Obviously, you know, a massive annoyance that for you that Cheryl, her TikTok account got taken down. So does that mean there's more reliance on the OnlyFans page?
Yeah, we're going to have to make income, extra income, because that's down. But while that's down, I probably won't pressure her to make any more content than we're already scheduled to make, because Cheryl will be tired and, you know, I don't want to overdo her.
I wonder if some people think he's pressuring her into this. There's no way that a lady in her 60s, a grandmother, wants to be online behaving like this. What would you say to those people?
Me and my wife are a team. We're very trusting. That's the foundation of any marriage, friendship, relationship. And we have communicated everything I've ever done with our OnlyFans. They can think what they want, but the best part about it, my wife has her own OnlyFans. We just don't promote it as much. It's for certain customers that want to see more explicit side of her, so.
So you're waiting for me to leave, aren't you, so you can make more videos?
Oh, no, we're just going to make love tonight.
That's right, yes.
Make sure it's all nice and subtle.
That's right, you fuss her tonight, yes. Yeah.
As with so many in America's southern states, Cheryl and Karan are big churchgoers.
Ready? Sounds like there's a party going on.
You're going to church. Lord, have mercy.
I love it here.
Although I'm starting to believe there's a genuine connection, I'm still curious about what really bonds this improbable couple.
The Lord is my shepherd.
If we was able to go back and change some choices, how many of us would go back and make some different choices? Hello, somebody.
What's your relationship like with your fellow churchgoers? Do they know that you're involved in more explicit videos?
I'm pretty sure the whole town knows. I'm like 100% sure on that, baby.
And if they don't, thank God for that.
Yeah, thank God.
You prefer they didn't?
Yeah, we want the people at church watching us, you know, make love.
And I saw you were both quite emotional in there.
Oh, yeah. I feel like I wouldn't have made it this far if I didn't have such a great relationship with God.
Have you ever had a crisis of faith?
I did. At one point in my life, I had some traumatic incidents happen to me, and it made me feel like God wasn't with me.
Whatever you sort of feel comfy offering, what did you go through?
I was raped at the age of 12, turning 13, the day before my birthday. And I felt like God wasn't there with me. I felt so alone. I felt like, why me? Why would this happen? And I was extremely hurt. I felt like God turned his back on me because you're supposed to protect me. You're my God. Like, and that's not how God works. And I had to learn that. I was angry, not at just myself, the world. And I had to learn, in order for me to heal properly, you got to let it go. And that's why I'm like appreciative of Cheryl, because when I met her, I told her about all these things because she'd been through similar things.
I'm sorry you've both been through, you know,
really difficult times.
That's my past. I've made a future with my wife. My past trying to hurt me, that's like trying to rob a house that I don't live in no more. I'm not there, so it can't affect me no more.
I went through things before him, and I learned how to get out of them and to clear my headspace, and he did the same process, and it worked for me, and it worked for him, so.
We're so different, but alike in so many ways.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's amazing, but it's sad, but amazing. I feel like my life is a lot better with Cheryl. She makes me feel like I'm a better man.
And he makes me feel like I'm a better woman.
The more you hang out with them, you see that they do share common ground. There's a sort of mutual understanding of what the other person's been through. And they do share these sort of incredibly difficult lived experiences. And I do think you could argue, you know, that is a sort of solid foundation for any relationship. Gang, that's me. Thank you very, very much for agreeing to have me over.
Well, you're welcome. We enjoyed having you.
Really appreciate it. And take care and good luck.
And we will.
It's undeniable that they split the camp. Some people adore what they're doing. They're totally on board. Other people are repulsed. Ron, thanks, mate. Online, anyone can say anything. You know what I mean? Everyone's a comedian. You know, people have such vicious tongues. In real life, lots of their loved ones are saying, but this is the happiest we've seen them. We think they're sort of really compatible and they just work.
We're going to miss you.
Oh, likewise.
Yes, we are.
All the best.
Bye.
Everyone's trying to work them out.
All right.
See you later. Take care. I think it's just a completely unique relationship that not many of us have ever experienced.